They are people.
Hey, art family, and thanks to all the new subscribers I've got recently. I know it's been a little while since I updated. I've been really busy with work. I just wrapped on a project for Jim Henson's Fraggle Rock, so I'm glad to be able to get back to doing some more of these videos. I asked people on Instagram and Twitter what kind of video or subject matter they'd like to see, and a lot of people requested more organic and natural stuff, so I'm going to try to do the next couple videos focusing on that and simplifying and organizing your colors in nature and also atmospheric effects of things in the distance. I start as I usually do with a light pencil sketch. This is a 4x6 B Super Deluxe sketchbooks, and I did a yellow ochre wash over everything just to get rid of the white, and then I added a blue in the top area because that area is totally in shadow. This sketch was a real struggle for me. Just a lot of things went wrong. Here in a moment, the clips on the sketchbook on my small easel that I was holding in my hand pop off, and my sketchbook flew off into the dirt, and my paint box fell over, and I had a headache that turned into a migraine, and I started getting a cramp from standing kind of bent over for the camera. So it just started all falling apart for me, and I almost gave up a lot of times during this sketch, but I wanted to continue it for this video because it's important to follow through with your sketches, even if they don't look right. If you follow through with a sketch and complete it, even if it looks bad, you'll still learn some lessons. You can still track and identify colors and learn something new out of every mistake you make. Most painting, in my experience, and I may just be a bad painter, is really in the corrections you make and the way you can pull the nose up on the plane. It has more to do with that than knowing what you're doing or the direction you're going. So now I'm just comparing and contrasting areas. The areas that are getting hit with the warm light of the sun, I'm putting in yellow ochre and white. And it's not quite white enough, so you'll see me kind of changing and adapting the colors. And I also notice that I'm using too much warm burnt sienna and white, so I try to add some blue, some complement to that. And I'm just trying to dance around the picture and look at the whole picture as a group of shapes of value. And I'm trying to get the right general shapes of value that I can build the image off of. This is a very complicated scene, full of rocks and all these tiny little details. So it's really crucial that I erase all the detail and just get the most simple picture I can. So to do that, I close one eye and I squint the other eye really tight. And it just gets rid of all the detail and it gets rid of all the color, and it just reduces the image down to just the value of what I'm looking at. So I'm seeing these shapes of value, these dark shapes, and I'm just sort of like puzzle piecing the image together with these little chunks of value. One thing I'm making sure I do is ignoring most of what I see in the water, because there's a lot of activity. It's a rushing creek, so there's a lot of highlight activity. There's a lot of blue atmospheric light from the sky that's getting picked up. I'm ignoring all of that and just painting it as if that's not there. So here I'm putting in some of the mossy green rocks underneath, and I'm just sort of picking up some of the details. It's not terribly important because I'm going to come back over this with the light blue and some white and varied color, but I'm just trying to give some sense that there's some stuff, activity happening under this water. And now that I have the like lower bits of the water, I'm starting in with the general tone of the water that I see underneath the highlights. It's sort of a green and a brown, so I'm taking green and adding some red to it. It's at this point in the picture, if you can't tell, I'm completely lost. I've made too many left turns. I've gone in a direction I don't know, and I don't even know what I'm painting anymore. It just looks awful. It looks terrible. All the darks are the same dark. All the lights are the same light. It's awful. It looks really bad. And I feel awful. I feel like an absolute failure. I feel like Maybe I've made a huge mistake. What am I doing with my life? Maybe it's not too late for grad school. I'm stupid. My childhood tormentors are correct. I'm a failure. And I just have to stop and slow down and just think, okay, what do I know? And what do I see that's wrong? Okay, I know that the atmosphere is blue as a secondary source of light, and I'm missing it completely. So I start to pop in my atmospheric lights, my blue lights, which is a reflection of the blue of the sky in the shadow areas. So I start placing my blue shadows next to my warm shadows to try to get some contrast there. And then I decide to just to go all in and really take a risk and just start punching in the darks. And I start with, I use a little bit of black, because with gouache, I don't mind using some black just to sort of get darks where I want darks. I mix it with blue or yellow ochre or burnt sienna, and I just try to start chiseling in the image. And I just figure, look, it's already a huge failure, so I might as well fail hard. And so I go all in with the darks. Cautious of going too crazy with the darks, though, because I don't want to add so much detail that it's confusing and distracting. I'm still trying my best to squint and simplify the image as much as possible. That's the most important read, is the simple read of the image. And rocks are a good thing for simplifying. They're fairly geometric, and the main thing you want to do is just break it down into the facets of where it's facing the light and where it's facing away from the light. So your areas that are warmer, higher saturated, and very, very light facing the light source, or in the shadow, maybe they're picking up atmospheric blue light, or they're just darker, or a shade darker. You can break it down into facets. So we're halfway through and I'm feeling a little bit better about this sketch. Even though I almost threw it into the creek, I'm continuing on. I'm trying to push on, keep going, and keep chiseling in the shapes, simplifying the rocks, and chiseling in the negative shapes around the rocks. And continuing as I chisel the shapes, to try to mix the temperature of the color I'm putting down to add some kind of contrast to the shadows and interest. So I have blue next to a burnt sienna. I keep the values similar, but I'm using complementary colors, some reds in the green, some orange in the blue, if there was yellow, some purple in the yellow, but keeping the value the same so that if you close your eyes and squint, you're still getting the same value reading, but when you look at it in full color, you're getting a nice vibration. Never be afraid to use your fingers to push the paint to either erase what you did or try to smear it for a kind of effect. Try to be fearless when it comes to the sketch. Just have fun with it. Try to enjoy it and be experimental. Use your fingers. You never know what kind of tricks you might learn. Using my fingers in some taught me some tricks for atmosphere that I used in a recent book I did for the backgrounds where it was all watercolor, so I did wet into wet. And used my thumb to smudge in the distant trees. It just created a very soft, distant effect that I was trying to go for that I learned just by messing up in my sketchbook. So now that I'm sort of happy with the general shapes, I dropped my towel. Now that I'm happy with the general shapes, I'm gonna start putting in those highlights on top of the water. And one thing I notice is that they're not the same. It's not just white sitting on top of the water. There's some really subtle shifts of very light blue where it's picking up a reflection of the atmosphere, and then some very white lights and a lot of warmer whites, but I'm also noticing that there's some areas where it's just like solid white, which I actually go and get a tube of white and put a fresh spot of white so that I can get just totally clean white for, because that's where the sunlight is being reflected directly into my eyes, and it's as white can get. And here I'm continuing to build on the facets of these rocks. I'm noticing every time you put down a color, it changes your whole relationship between from color to color with the value and the color. So when I put in some lights, it makes the others not as light as they need to be, or not as light as I thought they were. So I have to come back with an even stronger light or an even stronger dark. And then that changes other things. And so you have to just keep sort of slowly moving this image until it gets into the general area that you want it. And now that I'm getting into the lighter side of the water, I'm noticing some rocks that I missed in the water, which are wet and they're covered in water, so they have tons of highlights. But I'm trying to divide the water around the rocks and then put in a tone for the rocks, and then I can come back with the highlights on top. One lesson learned for me, which is an obvious one, was just the material difference between the rocks that are in the water and the rocks that are out of the water. The rocks out of the water had a lot more of what is called a Lambertian reflection, or a dull reflection, so they weren't shiny, so the light gets scattered when it bounces off of them, so they have a very dull color to them. But the rocks that are wet obviously are very glistening and shiny, so you have a lot more atmospheric light that's getting reflected in the shadow. You have a lot more white highlights on them as well. I end up talking about this point in a sketch just about every video. At this point, as I say in most of my videos, I'm just sort of noodling away at the tiny bits of detail. My major relationships are about where I want them, and I could just call it a day right now if I wanted to. I feel like the lessons have been learned, but I'm just kind of pushing it a little further and seeing what more of the story the image can tell. I like to take the tape off usually when I'm about 10% to finish. As soon as I'm done with all the bigger shapes, I'll take the tape off just so I can kind of get an idea of what it's going to look like when it's done. I'm starting to add in some of the branches and little leaves and stuff around the image. I don't want to distract from the creek though, or add too much around the actual, what I want to be the interesting point of the image. I'm also adding these reflections of the atmosphere that I'm noticing on the ivy. There's like a bunch of roots and ivy, and in the shadow they're very lit up, but they're like solid blue, like a nice soft blue where they're picking up the atmosphere. I'm getting a little anxious because I feel like the image is too much. There's too much going on. So I decided to take a really big risk here. And I just take some clean water, some dirty water, lightly, and just sort of start pushing around the edges. I feel like it has too many hard edges all over. So this is a risk. And I've done this before at the end of a really nice sketch and just gone right back to the white of the paper, because gouache is very temperamental in that way. But I'm trying to be very careful, just wet it up so it all gets soft, and then start blending and smudging and just softening up all the edges on the bottom side and on the top side, because I just feel like it's distracting from the actual creek. I want all my detail and contrast to be on that creek, because I want that to be the point of interest. And that's going to be it. I hope you found something helpful in this demonstration. Based on the feedback online, a lot of people have a lot of questions about gouache, so I'm assuming most of the future videos I do will be gouache-centric and trying to answer questions about using gouache. If you have any other questions or comments, you can leave them in the comments or contact me on social media. And in the meantime, take risks, have fun, follow through, and happy sketching.